light. Light seems obvious. Visible light is the reason that you can watch me on this video. But in chemistry, we need to expand our definition of light to electromagnetic radiation. Electromagnetic radiation goes beyond visible light. It includes gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet light, visible light, infrared, microwaves, and radio waves. When we consider this, what we're thinking about with light is different energy levels. Gamma rays, very high energy. Radio waves, which are passing through me right now, very low energy waves. Visible light is the light that allows us to see. When we think about light and electromagnetic radiation, it's made of three components. Wavelength, given by lambda, frequency, given as nu, and amplitude, or intensity. When we think about these parts of waves, we can think about a simple ocean. Whenever we look at the distance between waves coming in, that's our wavelength. How often a wave hits the shore, that's our frequency. And then the height of the wave. If we're on North Shore in Hawaii, we'd have a large amplitude. If we're on the Gulf, we'd probably have a small amplitude. When we consider these components, we can also think about two other factors. The speed of light, c, which is 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second, and energy. C is equal to wavelength times the frequency. Energy is equal to Planck's constant times the frequency. Therefore, our energy is going to be related to our frequency. The higher the frequency, the higher the energy. The lower the frequency, the lower the energy. The other part that we should think about with electromagnetic radiation is how the different types of electromagnetic radiation relate to different chemical processes. If we think about visible light has sufficient energy for electron changes. Once we understand the atomic structure, what is happening in visible light is that it is moving from one energy level to another. If it is being absorbed, that means that there is enough energy to make a ground state electron jump to a higher energy state. If light is being emitted, that means a high energy state is decaying back down to a ground state. In comparison to visible light, infrared energy is only sufficient to stretch and bend covalent bonds. In this unit, we're going to be focusing on visible light. As you learn more and more chemistry, you're going to see the other utility of the electromagnetic radiation spectrum.